We want to evaluate the given expressions involving factorials. So let's start with a review of factorials. For n factorial, n must be a positive integer, where n factorial is the product of positive integers less than or equal to n. So notice how for n factorial, we start with a factor of n. Each factor decreases by 1 until we end with the factors of 2 and 1. So for example, 6 factorial is equal to 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. It's also true that n factorial can be written as n times n minus 1 factorial. So for example, 8 factorial is equal to 8 times 7 factorial, because if we expanded 7 factorial, we would have 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. And by definition, 0 factorial is equal to 1. Factorials occur in topics such as combinatorics as well as the binomial theorem, but for this video, we're going to focus on just evaluating expressions involving factorials. So 7 factorial is equal to 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. Of course, we could find this product by hand, but let's go ahead and use a calculator. Many scientific calculators do have a factorial key, so we'll go ahead and show this two ways. First, do it the long way. Of course, we could leave off the factor of 1, but 7 factorial is equal to 5,040. Or using the factorial key, on this calculator we can press 7, math, arrow over to PRB for probability, option 4 is factorial, and enter. Of course, the result is the same. Let's go and take a look at our second example. There are a couple ways of simplifying this, so we'll go ahead and show both. First, let's go ahead and expand 8 factorial and 6 factorial. So we'd have 8 times 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 all over 6 factorial, which would be 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. Notice we can simplify this fraction. 6 over 6 simplifies to 1, 5 over 5 simplifies to 1, and so on. All these simplify to 1 over 1. Therefore, the result is just 8 times 7, which is equal to 56. Another way to get the same result that would require less work would be to recognize that if our denominator is 6 factorial and the numerator is 8 factorial, we can write 8 factorial as 8 times 7 times, instead of expanding this, we could write times 6 factorial. In this form, notice that 6 factorial over 6 factorial would simplify to 1, giving us the same result of 8 times 7, or 56. And then for the last example, again we can approach this two ways. First, approach it the long way by expanding each factorial. Notice the denominator has 2 factorials here, so we'll first have 7 factorial. And then we have 3 factorial, which would be 3 times 2 times 1. And now we'll go ahead and simplify. 7 over 7, 6 over 6, and so on. Now notice we have 10 times 9 times 8 in the numerator, and we have 3 times 2 times 1 in the denominator. We'll notice that 9 and 3 share a common factor of 3. So there's 1 3 and 3, and 3 3s and 9. And also the 8 and the 2 simplify because they share a common factor of 2. There's 1, 2, and 2, and 4 2s and 8. Notice how this simplifies nicely to 10 times 3 times 4, which would be 120. Let's show this another way. Again, noticing that we have 10 factorial in the numerator and 7 factorial in the denominator, we could write 10 factorial as 10 times 9 times 8 times 7 factorial. And then for the denominator, we would have 7 factorial. And then we'll go ahead and expand 3 factorial, which would be 3 times 2 times 1. Notice how this requires less work. 7 factorial over 7 factorial simplifies out. And then again, we have a common factor between the 3 and the 9. There's 1, 3, and 3, and 3, 3s, and 9. And there's a common factor of 2 between 8 and 2. There's 1, 2, and 2, and 4, 2s, and 8. So the result is the same. We have 10 times 3 times 4, which is 120. Let's go and verify this one on the calculator. We have 10 factorial. Press math. Left arrow 1's 2 probability, option 4, divided by, in parentheses, we have 7 factorial times 3 factorial. We need these parentheses to make sure both of these factorials are in the denominator. So we have 7, math, left arrow, option 4, and then 3 factorial, 3, math, left arrow, option 4, close parenthesis, and enter. So we have simplified this correctly. I think we'll go ahead and stop here for this video. I hope you found this helpful.